Why won't one? Starting to rain.
The upload. Today we're talking about cryptocurrency. Crypto now seems like it's been around forever, but it's really quite a new invention. Were you an early adopter?
I was one of the first that was in this market. There seemed to be a new way of financial transactions, a new way of money, something that we could completely reinvent and change some of the legacy financial systems around the world and really give power back to the people.
Yeah, it was a real shift in the way that the world works. And let's recap the basics. So, central to cryptocurrency is
the distributed ledger technology, the tech that keeps track of all
transactions. And what this means is you can have a decentralized system without having to trust any one party, like old-fashioned banks.
One of the reasons why I got involved so early was that you could stay anonymous.
Yeah, the features of cryptocurrency very much fit into that early mindset. It was all about finding an alternative to centralized systems. It was kind of a countercultural punk ethos. The whole point of the distributed ledger is you're not trusting any one person to keep track of who has what money or how they're spending. It's all out there in the open for anyone to see, and yet you can remain secretive.
But not everybody now wants to keep up this crypto legacy. They don't share this attitude anymore. We've seen institutions, businesses, even governments experimenting with crypto, which doesn't really fit into its original radical counterculture mold.
Yeah, it's kind of weird today to think of people not using cryptocurrency. It's so mainstream now. You know, I'm almost nostalgic for the feel of cash. Good old-fashioned paper and coins. First they changed the paper notes to plastic notes, and now it's just all digital. There's nothing to hold on to.
It was great just to be able to have a little bit of money to play around with.
I think the same thing in the UK.
You
can't see it today when you just
you
best guess? That laptop was stolen from Albion. Data on it outlines Albion plans to withhold much-needed supplies from this borough. If people are worried about where their next meal is coming from, they don't worry so much about eating the occasional Albion brand knuckle sandwich.
Shit.
You've kicked so many Albion asses that Tower Hamlets looks like the end of Hamlet.
Brilliant.
The people have certainly noticed. One enterprising individual wants to help you fuck up the old King Albion once and for all. I'll push you his coordinates.
I mean, what was the first thing that happened when Britain sealed itself up? First stuff stopped from coming in was fresh food. I mean, we could live without fresh food. I mean, everyone's quality of life got infinitely worse than we could live without. The most damaging part was when the radioactive isotopes stopped coming in. Now, radioactive isotopes, that's what we use for cancer screening, cancer treatment. Now, that stuff, it has a short half-life. Used to save hundreds of thousands of lives just by screening for cancer, let alone testing for cancer. But that stuff has a half-life of 66 hours. As soon as those walls went up, there was just no time to bring it into the country, and that is when people started dying. And then the medicines just can't stockpile. There was a moment before it took place when actually there were some efforts to try and stockpile some of the medicines. There were some things that could be done. For a lot of it, there was simply nothing that could be done. We had a major problem with drugs for schizophrenia. So we saw such an uptick in kind of attacks on the street and people suffering on their own because they didn't have a mental health problem. Those drugs simply couldn't be stopped. We eventually found the same thing that we weren't used in the UK. And the problem is,
Dolce drives now enabled.
We never had. For hundreds of years, we produced under half of our own food. So as soon as those walls went up, we started having significant material problems.
I think I hit somebody.
Britain always told itself it had this national myth, right? That it would, because it got through the war, that it could go through any kind of hardship. I mean, that was really the case. People during the war were far more frightened than some of this historical stuff makes out. Now, what did we see? People don't want to go through that stuff. They were desperate for the things that they had before, and they were desperate for the ones that they had.
Hi.
Yo, Wagwan. You're dead sick, innit? Yeah, I can tell. You got that hard look, yeah? Big ups on booting Albion's ass all over the ends. Ah, big ups. Them Albion pagans are the reason a lot of these people are out here. Do you know what I mean? No jobs, no flat to live in. And worse, Albion's been hoarding supplies. Food, toilet paper, and whatever's meant for shelters and kitchens. They're getting fat off all that.
All right, it's all good. We'll get on with it. You'll have your supplies in no time.
I allow that, cuz. It's not what I'm on about. I need this for ourselves, you get me? Get our hands dirty. You showed us that. But I might need some help keeping the Albion mercs from bashing heads, get me? A distraction lag. Got some fast wheels you can use, you know. You blaze around the borough while we pull the job. Are you in?
My kind of fun.
Right. Right, cos, we're in position. You, Brian? Kick it!
Fight the power! Albion mercs out of the hamlet!
The faster you blaze through the bar, the better. Cause damage and get attention. Slow down and Albion will come after our asses, cos. Do what you gotta do to get their attention.
Piece of cake.
Control to all units, possible hostiles near your
location. Take back the borough! Tower hamlet is yours! Not there! Over.
Fight Albion for a long breath! They will never surrender!
up against your oppressors!
Albion breathes fear!
Albion mercenaries, off our street!
Another lorry full. Keep going. We're going to clean out this place.
Every Albion soldier in the borough is after you. Let's give them a show, shall we?
That was brill. I don't even care if my wheels are trash. We got everything out of that warehouse, and the people know Albion was holding. This is gonna get everyone in the ends on board, you know.
Amazing. Spread the word, okay? We need everyone to fight. Dead Sick's trying, but the people have to rise up as well.
Yeah, I hear what you're saying, cuz. Just don't lose my digits, all right? Cheers.
The people of Tower Hamlet are already giving Albion the bum's rush. Well done.
Wicked. Yo, what's up?
All right, look,
You tell anyone I said this and you'll get a fucking slap, but I love this team, cuz. Real basket-hard cunts, the lot of us.
You say that like we can't get any better.
Hey, I ain't saying we're done. Like, London's just a start, yeah? The world needs DedSec, fam. Like, seriously.
Feels good, innit?
What?
Winning. I just watched the oldest lady I've ever seen knock a spider right out the air with a cane. It was wicked. And then she said, that's from DedSec. Actually, she said, ah, fuck my hip. But I could tell she meant the first one.
I know, right? But there's more to do. We have to keep pushing.
Yeah, but you've got to celebrate the small things. Now, excuse me, but I have an optic video of a kick-ass old lady to upload.
And they're mackets. It's a bit weird. You never think well, but it's odd.